There are two types of fear. One you experience while lost in a cave after hitting an 8-vein of diamonds, with no food and only one heart. The other, the one we'll be discussing today, is the intensely unpleasant feeling that you get with the anticipation of something dangerous, evil, or unsettling. So, what is a jump scare? A surprise change in visuals or audio that startles or shocks someone to evoke a physical reaction, jumping or holding your breath. So what is the difference between just being startled versus being truly in fear?
Startling is temporary. True fear is forever.
I don't know, he probably said that at some point in his life. I don't know that guy. Jump scares rely on a huge of scary and don't last very long and allow you to move on pretty quickly. True fear elicits your fight or flight response, but you aren't allowed to act on it. Time slows down as you may try to run, but all you can do is wait for whatever is causing you fear to carry out its intention. Don't Scream. Released just last year, it took Twitch and YouTube by storm. People couldn't stop playing it, but why? Well, I can't lie, pretty funny to watch people get jump scared. But it's not a scary game necessarily. Creepy, sure, and it gets the atmosphere right. But is walking around in a forest on edge because you might get startled at any moment really scary? Or are you just anxious because you know another jump is coming?
Okay, Josh, well, Don't Scream is pretty scary for me, so if it's such a stupid, unscary game, what are you even looking for in a horror game?
Glad you asked. There's a few things you gotta get right. So, let's talk about them.
Dude, give me my sunglasses back.
To build fear, you have to build the expectation of fear. No one plays the new Ratchet & Clank game and holds their breath in anticipation of something jumping out at them or grabbing them. On the other hand, playing Lethal Company and literally just standing in that first big open room is enough to pucker your chocolate speedway. Building on that, the reason that you're afraid in Lethal Company is not because your friends left you stranded without a flashlight. It's because you're standing in a dark, open warehouse with your friends screaming, lights buzzing, and footsteps that you don't know where they're coming from, footstepping. The setting has to be just right. No one gets scared walking through a flowery meadow in the middle of the day with cute animals and flowers. You've got to play on popular settings of fear. Dark, cramped spaces, abandoned houses, liminal spaces, or childhood fears. A great example of this is the game Death Park, mostly because I hate clowns. And dolls. God, I hate dolls. Another crucial part of being scared is feeling restricted. This restriction can be anything, from chances to escape, to being too dark in the room, not being able to hear, being lost, feeling trapped. Imagine this. You're being chased in a wide open field in broad daylight by a very slow killer with a mask and maybe a large knife. But right now, he's unarmed for some reason. Also, you suddenly have a full auto shotgun like that BS street sweeper from Cold War and a running car. You blast the guy in the face big time and drive off. Now, what was so scary about that? You have no urgency. You have no chance of getting snuck up on. You're overpowered compared to your opponent, and you have a perfectly good chance of escaping. No restriction. Now imagine the same scenario, but it's nighttime. You're in a dimly lit alleyway backed up against a corner. Old Mikey's after you again. Better reach for that street sweeper. Oh, never mind. You dropped it earlier. Your aggressor now has a knife, and he's closing in on you. You have nowhere to go but to just yell, kick, and scream until he stabs you. Now you tell me, which of those situations is scarier? Now, to be fair, to some people, classic slashers just might not be scary. I mean, usually they're just dudes with a mask and a knife. So when you got all your ducks in a row, and you think you're making a scary scene but it just ain't doing it, this is where abnormality or uncanniness comes in to save the day. This is why Backrooms games, the Silent Hill series, and the Evil Within series are so scary. Their monster designs are sometimes so outlandish you don't even recognize it. Or they're just close enough to being human, but maybe just a little bit off. Or maybe a lot of bit off. Now, controversially, I think that Poppy Playtime might just have the best fear-inducing, butthole-puckering moments of any horror game in recent years. First, when you encounter Poppy in the hallway, it's so tall and it's almost instinctual to look up and see what you're dealing with. Spoiler, it's not good. This makes you feel so small and helpless that all you can do is scuttle away into the vents like a little mouse. And once you're in the vents, you're not even safe. It's only just the beginning. As you make your way through a claustrophobic maze with Poppy cutting you off all the time, it really makes you feel helpless and trapped. Two of the most frightening and dread-inducing emotions. So if you think you got it all, let me show you an absolute masterclass in executed on these four pillars. This scene has stuck with me forever as the scariest, most fear-instilling scene ever. The first pillar, expectation. You're watching an Insidious movie. Of course you're expecting to get scared at any moment. The setting, dark, cramped basement with weird trinkets. Restriction, here's what really ramps up. She's on the ground with the wind knocked out of her, and for you, the viewer, there seems to be no escape from camera angles being low to the ground, and the best of all, abnormality. I mean, come on. Just look at the way this thing crawls off the table. Crawls over to her. The noise it's making. At this point, I don't even care about the monster design. I'm just trying to find the courage to breathe. So, what's the real problem and how can we fix it? The real problem is, there's actually too much scary in horror games and movies. I think that people forget that there's more to horror games than just being scared. It's about atmosphere and building expectation. A satisfying scare has to be earned. It feels like they have to constantly remind you that you're in a horror game with cheap jump scares. If it's not a scary moment, don't make it scary. Make it a little weird or unsettling or build tension or use good world building. I don't need to be reminded that I'm playing a horror game or watching a horror movie by being startled unnecessarily. If it's scary, I'll know. Now go off and scare the hell out of people. Thanks for watching.
Okay, Josh, well, Don't Scream is pretty scary for me, so if it's such a stupid, unscary game, what are you even looking for in a horror game? Dude, give me my sunglasses back.